filming this. It is going right up to YouTube because we want the rest of the school community to see it. Just to let you know, it's a little bit of a sampling of theater throughout the, or theater history throughout the canon. We chose 7 pieces that we thought really represented the way theater has gone from Greek, where they invented it, to modern day, to what we know now. We went from Greek to magical realism. All in your program. Just the word of warning, there is some language in this.
Yay!
A little bit of cursing.
We can't even get our 6-inch ladies' comforters, which we used to keep as leather rations when all else failed. Well then, if I found a way to do it, would you be prepared to join me in stopping the war?
By the Holy Twain, I would, even if I had to take off my book, this very dangerous
dream. Me too. Even if I cut myself into, like, flatfish and give half myself to the cause.
And I as well. I have to climb to the top of Tagetus so I can see the Lichos piece when I stop there.
Then I will tell you my plan. There is no need to keep it back. Ladies, if we want to force our husbands to make peace, we must give up.
We must give up what? Go on.
Then you'll do it.
If we be, we'll lay down a lodge for it.
We must give up sex.
What are you doing?
Hey, I see tears. Will you do it or won't you? Answer.
I won't do it. I won't do it. I'll let the war go on.
Weren't you the flatfish who was ready to cut herself up a moment ago?
I still am. I'll do that or walk through fire or anything, but give up sex? Never! Lizard's shot of darkness, there's just nothing like it.
What about you?
I'd rather walk through the fire, too.
I didn't know we women were so beyond redemption. The tragic poets are right, after all. All we want is to have our fun and get rid of the baby. My Spartan friends, will you join me? Even if it's just the two of us, we might yet succeed.
Well, it's a sad thing, my dear. For a woman to sleep alone, we get to a prayer. But we want to do it. For the sake of peace.
Lampito, darling, you're the only real woman among a lot of them.
Hello. Suppose we did do what you said, which heaven forbids.
But if we do that, how would that help end the war?
How? Well, think about it. You're at home wearing your sheerest lawn negligees and the men are all like grandmas and they can't wait to leave into bed. And then you absolutely refuse. That'll make them make peace soon enough, you'll see.
Didn't you mind how Menelaus threw away his sword when he saw but a glimpse of Helen's breasties?
But look, what if they divorced us?
That wouldn't do them much good, would it? They'd have no more use than skinning the same dog twice.
You know what you can do with those imitation dog things. Oh, anyways. What if they take hold of us and drag us into the bedroom by force?
Put into the door.
And if they hit us, and force us to let go?
Well, you've got to be as damned unresponsive as possible. There's no pleasure in it if they have to use force and give pain. And no man is ever happy if he can't please his woman.
Well, I think it's a good idea. We agree.
And we do as well. We will try to persuade Ormond to make peace and meet. But I didn't see how you're ever going to get the Indian riffraff. Takes you sense.
We will. We'll see.
Not saying name, for the warships have already sailed, and we have the bottomless fund of money in the famous temple.
Don't think we even see to that. While we take care of the sexual side of things, so to speak, all the older women have been instructed to seize the Acropolis on pretense of making sacrifices.
A great notion. It seems as if it will work.
Well then, Lampito, why don't we confirm the whole thing now by taking an oath?
Tell us the oath and we'll swear.
Well spoken. Officers? Down, like so. Now bring me the limbs of the sacrificial victim.
What sort of oath are you trying to give us?
The one who actually talks about filling up the shield with the blood of Felicity.
This oath is about peace. We can't possibly take it over a shield.
What do you suggest then?
Well, we could slot a full-grown cotton. No!
Mm-mm. Well, what sort of oath do you suppose we do?
I have an idea. If you like, we could get a large black cup and put it on a round, get Felicia's vine's blood, and swear over it that we won't put any water in it.
Now that's the kind of oath I like to hear.
A cup in a wine jar, somebody.
My dears, isn't it a welcome cheer? You have to leave and touch it.
Oh, goddess of persuasion, and thou, O lady of the loving cup, receive with favor this sacrifice from your servants, the women of grace. Amen.
Lovely red blood, and how well it flows.
And how sweet it smells, for the bye casters.
Let me take the oath first.
Not unless you draw the first lot, you don't.
Let Pinto and all of you take hold of the cup. One of you repeat after me, and the rest of you signify assent. I will not allow either boyfriend or husband.
I will not allow either boyfriend or husband
to approach me in an erect condition.
Don't make my knees are giving away.
And I will live at home without any sexual activity.
And I will live at home without any sexual activity.
Wearing my best makeup and most seductive dresses.
Wearing my best makeup and most seductive dresses.
To inflame my husband's ardor.
To inflame my husband's ardor.
But I will never willingly yield to his desires.
But I will never willingly yield to his desires.
And should he force me against my will.
And should he force me against my will.
I will be wholly passive and unresponsive.
I will be wholly passive and unresponsive.
I will not raise my legs towards the ceiling.
I will not raise my legs towards the ceilings.
I will not take up the lion on a cheese grater position.
I will not take the lion on a cheese grater position.
As I drink from this cup, so will I abide by this oath.
As I drink from this cup, so will I abide by this oath.
And if I do not abide by it, may the cup prove to be filled with water.
If I do not abide by it, may the cup prove to be filled with water.
Do you all agree?
We do.
I will dispose of the sacred remains.
Not all of them. Let's share them, as friends should.
Greetings, one and all. Pay heed to what you're about to witness with great care. For here we present a mortal slave that shows life is not ours to keep. Pay heed, no matter how you spend your days, never forget the end will come. Sin which feels so sweet in the here and now will cause your soul to weep at the end of days. And when God calls your name and commands an account of your life, there is no turning back. Pay heed to the story of the summoning of every man.
Look at them all. There's not one creature who thinks of me and who knows me as their god. All of mankind drowning in their sin, blinded by the riches. Do they not have one consideration for the end of days? Why don't they treat me so? Traitors! I died for them. I bled for them. I gave them life from my very own. They so blindly ignore the riches that I lent to them. I must deliver swift justice. Every man who lives for pleasure alone, I must demand an accountant of his life. Death!
Who are you?
Here at your command, Almighty God.
Go to every man. Tell him he must present an accountant of his life before me, God.
So I will. Every man who lives in mockery of God's laws, every man who lives in frivolity, who lounges in riches, every man who lives so I will strike down to hell. And so comes every man. I can see the lust of the world in his eyes and hear the gentle person as well. Every man, hold! Where Where do you go so foolishly? Have you not a single thought for your maker?
What is it to you? Why do you want to know?
I've been sent to you by God.
Why?
Even though you clearly have forgotten him, he has not forgotten you.
Ah, and what does God want with me?
The time has come to present an account of your life. He wants a reckoning from you, now.
I can't be expected to give an account just like that. So little warning, I need more time.
This is not a pilgrimage you can turn from. You will stand before God and show your many bad deeds and your few good ones. You will stand before God and speak on how you have spent your life. You must be off.
I'm not ready. Who are you? Why would I go with you anyway?
I am death. I fear no man. I spare no man. And it is God's will that all obey me.
Death. I wasn't expecting that, but it is in your power. Kind death, you could save me, because I could, from the goodness of my heart, maybe part with $1,000 so we could delay this pilgrimage a while.
No.
I wish to God I had never been born, to travel alone, my book unfinished. Who knew a life of joy and profit would lead to great pain? God help me, what do I do now? Who do I ask to accompany me? I know, my friend, fellowship. We have celebrated much together. He is my best friend. He would not abandon me in my time of need. There he is, fellowship.
Every man, how are you?
Every man, you look really bad. What's wrong?
It's true, I'm in a bad place.
So, tell me everything.
I want to, but...
No buts. I'm going to be your friend till the end of time.
But what if you heard what I had to say and you ran? That would ruin it.
What do you do that? They do that to you.
You don't know what I'm about to say.
If I say I'm going to stand by your side, that's what I'm going to do. I'm a man of my word. And even if I get sliced through the middle, my last thoughts will be how I stood up for a friend. And here I stand.
What's the nicest thing anyone's ever said for me?
Nonsense. A man only spouts words is useless. A man who acts on those words is a man indeed. Here I stand, your loving friend. Tell me your troubles.
Here goes. I have been called to take a journey, a pilgrimage, some might call it. For at its end, I must stand before God and give an account of my life. And nothing would please me more, dear friend, if you were to accompany me on this journey and stand before God.
You're kidding! Oh, you're not. Well, I have to admit, I did promise, but I have to admit, this is some trouble indeed. It's scary, but just, honestly, it scares the life out of me. I would do the same to anyone. Single person I take the trip with. Never mind, father.
But we've been friends forever. Does that mean nothing to you?
No.
Pray, walk with me.
No. I'm only one step with you.
Wait. You're gonna abandon me like that?
Yes. Hey, if I think of you, I'll cry.
Wow. God help me. My friends, my family, my wealth have all abandoned me. I am totally to blame. Who now?
No.
On very important business, Miss Fairfax states.
Isn't Mr. Worthing in his library?
Mr. Worthing went over in the direction of the rectory some time ago.
Well, pray ask the lady to come out. Mr. Worthing is sure to be back soon, and you can bring tea.
Yes.
Miss Fairfax, I suppose one of the good elderly women who are associated with Uncle Jack and some of his more philanthropic work in London. I don't quite like women who are associated in philanthropic work. I get so forward of them.
Miss Fairfax.
Pray allow me to introduce myself. My name is Cecily Cardew.
Cecily Cardew, what a very sweet name. Someone tells me we're going to be great friends. I like you already more than I can say. My first impressions to people are never wrong.
How sweet of you to like me after we've known each other such a comparatively short time. Pray sit down.
I may call you Cecily, may I not?
With pleasure.
And you will always call me Gwendolyn, won't you?
If you wish.
This all quite settled, is it not?
I hope so.
You here on a short visit?
Oh no, I live here.
Really? You've never heard of Hogwarts?
I don't think so.
Outside the family circle, Papa, I'm glad to say, is entirely unknown. I think that is quite as it should be. The home seems to me to be the proper sphere for the man. Once a man begins to become painfully feminine, he becomes certainly attractive, and I don't like that. Cecily, Mama's views on education are markedly strict, has brought me up to be extremely short-sighted, so do you mind not looking at me through my glasses?
Oh, not at all. I am very fond of being looked at.
You're here in a short visit, I suppose?
Oh, no, I live here.
Really? Your mother, no doubt, is a female relative in advanced years, resides here also.
Oh no, I have no mother, nor in fact any relations.
Indeed?
Yes, my dear guardian, with the assistance of Miss Prism, has the arduous task of looking after me.
Your guardian?
Yes, I am Mr. Worthing's ward.
It is certainly strange to mention to me he had a ward. How secretive of him. He grows more interesting hourly. I'm not sure, however, the news fills me with feelings of dumbness, delight. Cecily, I've liked you ever since I met you. But now that I'm now to state that now I know you, Mr. Williams Ward, I cannot help but express that I wish you were, well, just a little older than you seem to be. Not quite so very alluring in appearance. If I may speak,
yes. Oh, pray do! I think that when one has anything unpleasant to say, one should always speak with quite candid.
Well, to speak with perfect candor, I wish that you were fully 42 and
what?
More than usually plain for your age. Ernest has a strong...
Did you say Ernest?
Yes.
Oh, but it is not Mr. Ernest Worthing who is my guardian. It is his brother, his elder brother.
Ernest never mentioned to me that he had a brother.
I'm sorry to say they have not been on good terms for a long while.
Ah, that counts for it. Not even, but no man ever mentions that he has a brother, such it seems. Distasteful to most men. Cecily, you lit the quadrille of my mind. I was growing most anxious. It would be terrible if any cloud had come across a friendship like ours, but not ours. Of course, you are quite sure it is not Mr. Ernest Worthing, who is your guardian.
Quite sure. In fact, I am going to be his.
I beg your pardon?
Gwendolyn, there is no reason to hide this from you. Our little county newspaper is sure to chronicle the fact next week. Mr. Ernest Worthing and I are engaged to be married.
My darling Cecily, there must be some slight error. Ernest is engaged to me. The announcement will appear in the Morning Post on Saturday at the latest.
You must be under some misconception. Ernest proposed to me exactly 10 minutes ago.
I've been very furious for... He asked me to be his wife yesterday afternoon at 5:30. If you care to verify the incident, please do so. I never traveled on my diary. One should always have something sensational to read on the train. I'm so sorry if there's any disappointment to you, Cecily. I'm afraid that I have the prior claim.
Well, it troubles me to tell you if it causes you any mental or physical anguish, but it seems that if he proposed to you, he must have changed his mind.
If the poor fellow has been entrapped into any foolish promise, I should make it my duty to rescue him at once, with a firm hand.
If my dear boy has been entrapped into any foolish entanglement, I would never reproach him with it after we are married.
Do you allude to me, Miss Cardew, as an entanglement? You are presumptuous. On an occasion like this, it becomes more than a loyal duty to speak one's mind. It becomes pleasure.
Do you suggest that I entrapped Ernest into an entanglement? How dare you? This is no time to wear the shallow mask of manners. When I see a spade, I call it a spade.
I'm glad to say I've never seen a spade. It is obvious our social spheres have been widely different.
Shall I lay tea here as usual, miss?
Yes, as usual.
Done away with.
You mean killed?
Yes.
Why don't you say killed?
It sounds so brutal.
And you never saw this before then?
No, sir.
You're quite sure of that?
Yes.
Quite sure?
Yes.
And these stones, when did you first see them?
The night my husband was done away with.
Before that night, your husband was murdered. You never saw them, never before then?
No, sir.
Mrs. Jones, do you remember? About a year ago this spring, bringing home to your house a lily, a Chinese water lily.
No, I don't think I do.
You don't think you remember bringing home a water lily, growing in a bowl filled with small stones?
No, I don't.
I'll show you this bowl, Mrs. Jones. Does that refresh your memory?
I remember the bowl, but I don't remember...
You recognize the bowl then?
Yes.
Yours, is it not?
It was in my house, yes.
How did it come there?
How did it come there?
Yes, where did you get it?
I don't remember.
You don't remember?
No.
You don't remember about a year ago bringing home a bowl filled with small stones and some water and a lily? You don't remember tending very carefully that lily till it died? And when it died, you don't remember hiding the bowl filled with little stones on the top of your shelf closet and keeping it there until... You don't remember.
No, I don't remember.
You may have done so.
No, I didn't. I don't know anything about all that.
But you do remember the bowl.
Yes, it was in my house. You found it in my house.
But you don't remember the lily or the stones.
No, I don't.
Your Honor, I'd like to introduce this paper in evidence at this time.
What is it?
It's an affidavit taken in the state of Guanajuato, Mexico.
Mexico? Your Honor, I protest. A Mexican affidavit? Is this the United States of America, or isn't it?
It's properly executed, sworn in before notary, and certified by an American counsel.
Your Honor, I protest. In the name of this great United States of America, I protest. Are we to permit our sacred institutions to be thus?
What is the purpose of this evidence? Who signed it?
It is signed by one Richard Rowe. And its purpose is to refresh the memory of the witness at the point at issue and incidentally supply a motive for this murder. This brutal and cold-blooded murder
Your
of
Honor,
a sleeping
I
man
object.
By-
I object!
Objection sustained. Let me see the document. Perfectly regular. Do you offer this affidavit as evidence at this time to for the purpose of refreshing the memory for the witness at this time?
Yes, Your Honor.
I object.
Objection overruled.
I object to the introduction of this evidence as irrelevant, immaterial, illegal, biased, prejudicial, and...
Objection overruled.
Exception.
Exception noted.
I wish to read the evidence to the jury at this time.
Proceed.
I object.
Objection overruled.
Exception.
Noted.
Why is this witness himself not brought to be cross-questioned?
The witness is a resident of the Republic of Mexico and as such not subject to a subpoena to a witness to this court.
If he was out of the jurisdiction of this court, then how did you get
his affidavit was made voluntarily by the deponent into the furtherance of justice.
I suppose you didn't threaten him with some trumped-up charge or some other extradition or some...
Order! Proceed with that.
In the matter of the state of versus Helen Jones, I, Richard Rowe, do harangue disposed in state that I know the accused Helen Jones have known her for a period of over 1 year immediately preceding the date on the signature of this affidavit. That I first met the said Helen Jones in a so-called speakeasy somewhere in the West 40s in New York City. That on the day I met her, she went with me to my room, also somewhere in the West 40s in New York City, where we had intimate relations.
Oh.
And where we continued, and where I gave her a blue bowl filled with pebbles, also containing a flowering lily. That from the first day we met until I departed for Mexico in the fall, the said Helen Jones was almost a daily visitor to my room, where we continued to...
No! No!
What is it, Mrs. Jones?
Don't read! Don't read anymore!
Why not?
I did it! I did it! I did it!
You confess.
Yes, I did it. I object.
You confess you killed your husband?
Yes, I put him out of the way.
Why?
To be free.
To be free? Is that the only reason?
Yes.
If you just wanted to be free, why did you just divorce him?
Oh, I couldn't do that to him. I couldn't hurt him like that.
You were
hurt.
What? I said, wow.
Mrs. Jones, why? Why?
Your Honor, I'd like to request a recess to...
Court adjourned.
That's amazing.
we do now?
I don't know.
Let's go.
We can't.
Why not? We're waiting for Godot.
How they've changed.
Who?
Those two.
That's the idea. Let's make a little conversation.
Haven't they?
What?
Changed.
Very likely. They all do. Only we can't.
Likely? It's certain. Didn't you see them?
I suppose I did, but I don't know them.
Yes, you do know them.
No, I don't know them.
We know them, I tell you. You forget everything. Unless they're not the same.
Why didn't they recognize us then?
That means nothing. I too pretended not to recognize them. Then no one ever recognizes us.
Forget it. Would we...
Unless they're not the same.
Deed against the other foot!
Unless they're not the same.
Mister!
Off we go again. Approach, my child.
Mr. Albert?
Yes? What do you want? Approach.
Approach when you're told, can't you?
Mr. Godot.
Obviously. What is it? Approach. Will you approach?
What kept you so late?
I was afraid, sir.
Afraid of what?
Us?
Yes, sir.
And whose fault was it? Ours? Answer me!
I know what it was. He was afraid of the others.
How long have you been there?
A good while, sir.
You were afraid of the whip?
Yes.
The rowers?
Yes, sir.
The two big men?
Yes, sir.
Do you know them?
No, sir.
Are you a native of these parts?
Yes, sir.
Do you belong to these parts?
Yes, sir.
That's all a pack of lies. Tell us the truth.
It is the truth, sir.
Let him alone.
You let me alone. Do you know what time it is?
I don't know, sir.
How long have you been there?
A good while, sir.
Have I seen you before?
I don't know, sir.
You don't know me?
No, sir.
It wasn't you came yesterday.
No, sir.
This is your first time?
Yes.
Words. Speak.
Mr. Godot told me to tell you that he wouldn't be here today, but surely tomorrow.
Was that all?
Yes, sir.
You work for Mr. Godot?
Yes, sir.
What do you do?
I mind the sheep, sir.
Is he good to you?
Yes, sir.
He doesn't beat you?
No, sir.
Whom does he beat?
He beats my brother, sir.
Ah, you have a brother.
Yes, sir.
What does he do?
He minds the goats.
And why doesn't he beat you?
I don't know, sir.
He must be fond of you.
I don't know, sir.
Does he give you enough to eat? Does he feed you well?
Yes, fairly well, sir.
You're not unhappy. Do you hear me?
I don't know, sir.
You don't know if you're unhappy or not.
No, sir.
You're as bad as myself. Well, where do you sleep?
In the loft, sir.
With your brother?
Yes, sir.
In the hay?
Yes, sir.
All right, you may go.
What am I to tell Mr. Godot, sir?
Tell him you saw us. You did see us, didn't you?
Yes, sir.
Well, at last. What are you doing?
A pale for weariness.
Of climbing heaven and gazing on the likes of us.
Your boots. What are you doing with your boots?
I'm leaving them there. Mother will come just as me, but with smaller feet, and they'll make him happy.
But you can't go barefoot.
Christ did.
Christ? What has Christ got to do with it? You're not going to compare yourself to Christ.
All my life I've compared myself to him.
Yes, but where he lived, it was warm, it was dry.
Yes, and they crucified quick.
We've nothing more to do here.
Or anywhere else.
Don't go on like that, Gogo. Tomorrow, everything will be better.
How do you make that out?
Did you not hear what the child said?
No.
He said, Mr. Godot was sure to come tomorrow. What do you say to that?
Then all we have to do is wait on here.
Are you mad? We must take cover. Come on.
Pity. We haven't got a bit of rope.
Come on, I'm cold.
Remind me to bring a bit of rope tomorrow.
Yes.
Come on. How long have we been together all the time now?
I don't know. 50 years, maybe.
Remember when I threw myself into the Rhone?
We were grape harvesting. You fished me out. That's all Denbury.
My clothes dried in the sun.
There's no good harking back on that now. Come on.
Wait.
I'm cold.
Wait! I sometimes wonder if we wouldn't have been better off alone. Each one for himself. We weren't made for the same road.
It's not certain.
Nothing certain.
We could still part, if you think it would be better. No, it's not worthwhile now. No, it's not worthwhile now.
Well, shall we go?
Yes, let's go.
Night, you want to talk to me for months. What you want to talk about now?
Tomorrow's Friday.
I know what day tomorrow is. Don't think I know it's Friday? My whole life, I ain't done nothing but to look to see when Friday's coming. You gonna tell me it's Friday?
I
want to
know if you're coming home after work tomorrow.
I always come home, Rose. You know that. There ain't never been a night I ain't been home.
That ain't what I mean, and you know it. I want to know if you're coming straight home after work tomorrow.
I figure I hang out at Taylor's with the boys. Hang out at Taylor's, maybe.
I can't live like this. I won't live like this. You living on borrowed time with me. It's been going on 6 months now and you ain't been coming home.
I'll be home every night. Every night of the year. That is 365 days.
I want you to come straight home after work tomorrow.
Rose, I don't mess up my pay. You know that now. I don't got nothing but what you give me back. I take my pay and I give it to you. I just want to have a little time to myself. A little time to enjoy.
What about me? What's my time to enjoy life?
I don't know what to tell you, Rose. I'm doing the best I can.
You ain't been coming home but time enough to change your clothes and run off. And you want to call that the best you can do?
Oh. I'm going to see Alberta at the hospital. They said she's having the baby early. I won't be gone long.
Well, you ought to know. They went over to Miss Pearl's and got a gate today. They said you told
them to go ahead and lock them up. I said no such thing. Whoever told you that is telling a lie. Miss Pearl ain't doing nothing but telling a big fat lie.
She ain't had to tell me. It was right there on the paper.
I said nothing of the kind.
I read it right there on the paper.
What'd it say, huh?
It said you told them to take him.
Then they scooped that up. So did they scoop everything up. I don't care what they got on that damn paper.
Say the government sent part of his check to the hospital, other part to you.
I ain't got nothing to do with that if that's the way it work. I don't make up the rules about how it
works. Just like you did Corey. You ain't
You wouldn't sign the paper for Corey, but you signed it for Gabe.
I ain't signed it.
You signed that paper.
I told you I ain't signed nothing, woman. Only thing I signed was the release form. Hell, I can't even read. I ain't signed nothing about sending Gabe away.
I said send him to the hospital. You said let him be free. Now you went down there and signed him to the hospital for half his money? You went back on yourself, Jordan. You gonna have to answer.
Bruce, you been talking to Miss Pearl. She just want, man, she ain't got Gabe's rent. And get Gabe's rent money. That's all it is. She is liable to anything.
I seen you sign the paper, George.
You ain't seen nothing I signed. What's she doing got papers with my brother anyway? Miss Pearl ain't doing nothing but telling a lie. I'm gonna tell her that too. You ain't seen nothing I signed. You ain't seen nothing I signed.
Troy, that was the hospital. Alberta has a baby.
What is it? What's she having?
It's a girl.
I gotta go see her now.
Troy,
bro. Bro, what? I gotta go see her now. What's wrong? What is it?
Alberta died having the baby.
Alberta died? Dad, you say Alberta's dead?
They said they
got
all they
can
do for her.
The baby, how's the baby?
They say it's healthy. I wonder who's gonna bury her.
She wasn't living in the world by herself. She'll be fine.
I know she wasn't living in the world by herself.
That's the first thing that came out of your mouth. Who's gonna bury her like I'm just gonna take the task on for myself?
I'm your wife, don't push me away.
I ain't pushing nobody away. I just need a little room to myself, that's all. Little room to breathe. See now, I'm gonna tell you what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna take and build me a fence around this yard. See, I'm gonna build a fence around what belongs to me. And you stay on your side, see? And you come when you're ready. Then you can come on. Bring your army, bring your sickle, bring your wrestling clothes. I ain't falling down my villages this time. I'm not letting you sneak up on me no more. And nobody else got nothing to do with this. This is between you and me, man to man. Then, when the top of your list ain't Troy Maxson, then you can come. You can come knock on the front door. Anytime you want, I'll be ready.
Chain to the moon so it never strays from its beloved Earth again. One insider has been quoted as saying the White House hopes to raise revenues for Operation Moon Rescue by taxing lunatics, responding to allegations that cows are given salty milk because grass is contaminated. Government scientists are drafting plans to develop a new strain of cows that lives by eating astroturf.
I thought it was you! I tried to call you, but do you have any idea barbarian beer with a golf club!
Can you believe that? Like a caveman kills its dinner, fucking freak. I'm so upset.
Was it me and Drew?
Could have been you, living in that marginal neighborhood. Like, aren't you scared?
Isn't it past time to leave the Bronx behind?
But it wasn't me. I didn't die last night.
Goddamn vultures are having a field day with this. That's close-ups of Marisol Perez's pummeled body. I mean, what's the point? There's a prevailing sickness out there. The dark ages are here. It's a ghost climbing the city walls, and I've never felt more like raw food in my life. Am I upsetting you with this?
Yeah.
Good. Put the fear of God in you. Don't let them catch you not ready, okay? You've got to be prepared to really fight now.
Why do you say that? Did someone tell you to say that?
Today. You look like shit. You miss Puerto Rican yuppie princess of the universe. You never look like shit.
It's nothing. Let's get to work. Gotta get this manuscript off my desk.
Something happened to you last night? It's nothing.
Alright. It's my body. It feels like. It's like I fit into my clothes all wrong today. Every person on the subway this morning gave me shivers. I keep hearing children crying. They all look so hungry. I keep hearing burnt flesh. And now there's this woman with my exact name killed in my exact street last night. I had this dream. Black angel with beautiful wings. She came to my bed last night and told me she loved me. She seems so real, so absolute, virtuous, capable of lying, exalted, sublime, virtuous, powerful, fulgent?
Fulgent! Whoa! Yo, Marisol! That shouldn't happen. It's all Roman Catholic bullshit.
I feel so sorry. I feel so sorry for everything.
Look it. I think your dream is just like your moon's disappearance. It's all along the feeling of my jitters. I've never seen so much nervousness. It's still out there, paranoia is kind of our view. That shit can happen, you know?
I don't think the universe's disappearance is psychological. It's like the universe is senile, June. We're at the part of history where everything breaks apart. Do you smell smoke?
Wait, it's 9:30. You're expecting the smoke from that massive fire in Ohio to reach north by 9:30. Jesus, those are a million trees burning. Christ, you can smell polyester, burnt malls, false bones, bad novels. Whatever, I'm going on break. I'm going downstairs for coffee. You want anything?
Coffee's extinct, June.
Tea. I meant tea. I was supposed to come and see you drink. Carry on like normal. I swear, when we're not in cataclysm like this, that I'm going home. You okay?
Salt is in the food and mythologies of old and new. Ancient writers believed that angels turned into salt when they died. Popular mythology holds that during the fall of Satan, angels killed in battle fell into a primordial ocean, which was then fresh water. Today, the oceans are salted by the decomposed bodies of fallen angels.
I was a movie taxi driver. Robert De Niro, and the son of a gun never paid me.
Are you looking for someone?
The second AD said this is where I go to collect my pay for my working taxi driver.
This isn't a film company, sir. Publish science books? I think there's a film company on the 10th floor.
No, this is the place. I'm sure it's the place.
Maybe if I call security.
I mean, it was my big break. And of course, working with a dude like De Niro is like act of heaven. But come on, I still need the money.
I'm a busy woman, sir. I have a department to run.
I mean, I don't want to get temperamental, but Taxi Driver came out a long time ago, and I still haven't been paid.
What's security for you?
Christ, I have bills. I have rent. I have a toddler in Catholic preschool. I have an agent screaming for 10%. And how the hell am I supposed to pay for this ice cream? Did this ice cream is free? Did they cry about this shit out for nothing?
Jim! Someone on this floor!
Don't fuck with me, lady. I want to say not this year. From the TV movie of the week, I want to say Man on Fire and Vancouver the Price for CBS, and I really like that role.
Again.
The rest of the day off. Going to my